Thank you all for joining me in my first ever testimony. It's pretty cool. And I hope you get inspired for the youth and all of you, because my story brings hope to a world that is a little shuffle right now. So I'm going to start off this my testimony with my injury. Just to talk about the medical history a little bit, and then I will get into the good stuff, as we like to call it, in my paradise with Giorgio Frassati. So I moved into an off-campus house. I went to East Stroudsburg University. I was a junior transfer student from Nassau Community College. I played soccer there for 2 years, hoping that maybe I'd get a scholarship to play soccer, D1. That didn't happen, so I decided to go to East Stroudsburg and just hang them up. And I moved into our house with my two friends. And from what I understand, that day was a good day. I don't have a single clue what I did that day. It's a lost day at this point in my life, and it's a day that I don't want to remember anymore. But I guess early in the day, we got the cable guy to come over to our house, so I helped him out. He was trying to get one of the wires, into my room, but I realized that he couldn't get the wire because of the tree. So I got out there, it's a country. I didn't fall through here, that guy. So I helped him out. Did that, and I spoke to my mom. I was like, it's a good day, got the barbecue, we got the cable working. And then a little bit later that night, I don't know exactly what happened, nobody really knows. I took a tumble down off my roof and hit the back of my head. I guess it must have landed body first, hit the back of my head. I fractured my skull in 5 places. And lucky enough, one of my friends was actually going outside to go to use the bathroom, and he saw me laying down, and his name's Brian Publitz. He's also another man that I'm forever grateful. No, I don't know you guys, I'm sorry. I couldn't joke around, but yeah, I heard you guys. Yeah, I heard you guys playing, talking trash about Manchester United and all that stuff. But no, I didn't hear anything. So I waited for my coma. The day I left the hospital, and about 8 days later, I did not need, I went through a bunch of tests. Did cognitive, motor skills, all these other things. The only thing I didn't pass was the cognitive skills. And there's actually just one funny story that I think my parents love telling this story the most, because it's really funny. They didn't go through all these cognitive tests, and this is to tell you guys where I was in the hospital. I'm asked, I'm getting the letter F, and they go, I need you to come up with 3 words for the letter F. So of course everybody's probably thinking that this is New York, different way. I couldn't come up with 3 words, so I was like, alright, my first word was football, like regular American football. My second word was European football. So we have American football, European football. And then I'm just looking around the room, I look up and I say Federer. This was during the same time as the U.S. Open was on. I was watching the U.S. Open, and I go, Federer. And the doctor, the therapist, like, Federer, where did you get that from? And the nurse, one of the other nurses, she goes, he's watching the U.S. Open, he says Federer. And they're like, well, Kevin, that's good enough, but he did not get the 3 words. And I was just like, well, all right. But my parents will always call that story, because it's still the funniest thing they've ever seen. There's another chance I'm just going to say Federer out of
So, I also want to get one other thing, Kevin, that it's important to understand that when his mom, Christine, I guess, spoke to your cousin, the family knew nothing about Pier Giorgio, had no idea who he was. And so they were being asked to pray to someone they didn't know, but they did.
So I was released from I passed out your test, and I was released from the hospital on the 17th day. When I left the hospital, wheelchair out of the hospital. That wasn't my intention. We got to about 10, 15 feet from the hospital doors. I told the transporter, I'm like, you're good, this is enough here. I told him, I'm getting up, I'm walking out of here. I took my bags, walked out of the hospital. And then, we had to get my parents stayed in the Hackney Pass house, like a hotel that was across from the hospital. And while they were packing their stuff up, my older brother and I were on a football cache. I was on a football, and I was in a coma, just waking up, going to football. So then we went to East Strasburg, went to my house, you know, where it happened, went to my house, picked up some of my stuff, went to my team's club, I played club lacrosse, went to that went to their practice and stuff, and, you know, they had practice, and it was maybe one of the proudest, like, days of my life, because I walked down there, you know, I got a huge round of applause, just like you guys gave me a round of applause. For me, when I was walking down that field, I felt motivated. There was not a day that one died after I was released that I knew that I would get back to my school for the next semester. I missed one semester of school. I showed up. So I get home. I had to do outpatient therapy for this cognitive skills, and I did a little physical therapy also. I lost over 30 pounds. When I got hurt, I weighed 205 pounds. When I left the hospital, I weighed 170 pounds. So I lost a lot of weight. So, but went through the strength. I forgot what the place is called, but that's where I got my contact there. And when we first went there, the doctor said I was in a rare breed of people where I actually might get smarter. I sat there and I was like, well, I can smart. So he told me that all I had to do was hit my head 20 times harder and I was like, and she was just laughing and stuff. And I made like a, you know, funny joke to her. She's like, so what happened about that night? I was like, I don't know, I just fell off the roof and here I am and you're telling me I'm going to be smarter. And I right on my head, I was like, this is awesome. I'm getting smarter now. So I started that, then a month later, this is September now, I left the hospital September 15th or whatever. I left the hospital, and in October, I took a test that, I guess, compares what your brain's working at to people between, like, my age group, so 18 or 24. Usually, the doctor did not have a clue, like, she didn't really know my whole story, she didn't get a chance to look at my MRIs, they didn't come in that. So I knew. My mom and I were in there talking to her and stuff. We left there, and my mom, and she realized how bad it hurt. She's like, yeah, I don't think so either. So I take the test. Usually takes, for some people, 4 hours. It took me only 2 hours. I had to wait like a month to get my results. So I was in therapy and stuff, and I knew right away that I was healing much faster than people. And I was in a classroom, you know, I actually had a friend of mine I played soccer with also. He was in a coma. He was in a car accident a month before I got married. He's still got a long, he's doing well now, but it was very tough for me to see people still struggling maybe years later and knowing that I already knew right away something like in October, like I knew something good was happening to me. I knew that God, blessed Pier, Giorgio, Jesus had given me something. They gave me a second chance and it's showing up. And I felt bad in class. I didn't understand why I was doing so much better and they were still struggling. So I went through therapy, and then in November, I get my results. And the doctor, Dr. Micheletti, she said, you're amazing. My brain, about a month later, was already working like it was never heard. Never heard. And the crazy thing was, she finally sees the results. I damaged every single lobe in my brain, all 5 lobes, damaged, every single one. Every single one, there's not one lobe that did not have a bruise or anything. It was completely damaged. I was, that day, it's like, wow. But I stayed in therapy, they moved me up, though I was getting pumped up, and they moved me up into, I was actually the youngest kid in this group, but I was in a group of people with that dementia and Alzheimer's. And I walk in there, youngest kid, and then I go, Kevin, you introduce yourself. I'm like, it's Kevin, I was in a coma in late August, and I'm here now. I forget his name, he just looks at me and goes, you're here now? Like, you're almost out of here? I'm like, yeah, he goes, listen, you must have one hard head, man, because you're still going. I was like, no, I've always pulled that hard head. When I was a little kid, I pulled down a lot, hit my head, so something good was happening. So after I took that test, I actually went back up to my school for the end of the semester, for the last 2 weeks, since the therapist said it would be okay, and since I knew I was going back to school, we figured that was a good idea for me to get back up there, be with my friends again, and get myself, resituated with myself. So I finished off therapy in January, actually, late January. And then I went up for another checkup with my doctor in Lehigh Valley. And on that day, the day that I went there, he said I was 100%. Good to go. I fractured my skull in 5 places. Good to go. Swelling my brain, all healed. I was told that day that I could live my life again. No fear. So, what I did is I started playing lacrosse again. No fear. I was playing lacrosse within 6 months of being hurt. And if you were to watch, hockey and stuff, you have your enforcers. If I was touched, guess what? That kid was in big trouble. My friends, everybody knew. Now you get touched, guess what? You're getting a slash. Actually, my older brother played in the game, and I took a really big hit. And his first movement was straight to me, and then I was okay. And I was like, why don't you hit the kid? I'll be okay. Why don't you hit the kid? So, here I am now, age 24. Actually, recently just graduated school. Believe it or not, my grades did get better. I'm here talking to you guys. Now, the crazy thing about it is, when I first woke up from my coma, and the last day, the day I left the hospital, I told my mom, I was with somebody. I was with an angel. There was somebody with me. I know for a fact that mom is a young guy, short, built guy, and I was like, I was kind of tired, so I couldn't like explain more. So we said we talk more about it the next day. So the next day comes, and Dave, my older brother's downstairs with me, and I was like, Dave's a new guy. Let's call him Dave. My older brother goes, yeah, well, you're a lot bigger than most people anyway, so anybody short to you. So I was like, all right. So he's built, his hand, and I'm like, he's like a kid, he looked young, like my age. And I always will remember it because, when I first met him, I was in my room. My room was very, if you guys saw my college room.